Representative Schlossberg, I first want to thank you for taking the time after your busy schedule to really update us on the past 2 years of being here in the House of Representatives. Plus, we're going to finish up by taking a look ahead at what's ahead in 2015. So, a lot of things happened in the past 2 years. So take us through and what do you consider the biggest issues that you had to work through?
It's funny because I'm a sentimental person, as anyone who knows me will say, it's very strange to be sitting here and realize that 2 years have passed. It's been an incredible 2 years. It's been an absolutely fascinating and educational and invigorating experience, and I'm thankful to say that I still want to be here. And not only do I still want to be here, but I want to be here even more than when I was on the outside looking in. And particularly given all the things that we need to work on in Pennsylvania and in Allentown and South Whitehall. The two biggest issues I spent this past session talking about were education. We got some progress on education. Working with Senator Brown, we were able to find over the two-year session an extra $10 million over what Allentown was initially allocated. That's money that helped save school jobs, that helped keep our property taxes lower than they've increased. The truth is that it's still not enough. It's not nearly enough. Now, we need more funding. We need to find a way to fund charter schools fairly and in a manner that doesn't devastate the Allentown School District. We need to bring back some of the 400-plus teachers that were laid off as a direct result of the funding cuts that we sustained. But I don't want to sit here and say money's the only answer. It can't just be about money. Our curriculum and the way that we educate students is out of date. We have an obsession with standardized testing that I think is straight up dangerous to the students of Allentown and Parkland and to the future. Our education system needs a major overhaul if we're going to be able to generate a workforce that can compete and that can be successful. We teach kids about algebra that they may never have a use for, but we don't teach them how to balance a checkbook. I mean, we just don't have a modern day educational curriculum, and that's something that we're not giving kids a chance to get ready for the 21st century. That was the number one issue. It will still be the number one issue for me going forward. Transportation was a big deal, and no pun intended, it's kind of a fun issue to take a victory lap on for me. Act 89 that we passed back a little more than a year ago now helped to invest over $2 billion in transportation, in the transportation infrastructure in Pennsylvania. I was very proud to be the only House member from the Lehigh Valley delegation that voted yes. It's not necessarily fun to stand alone in politics, but this was bar none the right vote.
And make a tough choice.
Yeah, nobody liked doing what we did to fund the roads. Nobody likes asking people to go deeper into their pockets. And everybody came up with cute ways of discussing it. Let's be honest about it. We ask people to pay more. But we ask them to pay more for public good, for their roads, for their bridges, for their mass transit, for safer streets, and for more jobs. What we did will help create over 50,000 jobs in Pennsylvania, and thousands of those jobs are going to be in Allentown and in South Whitehall. We widened Route 22. Back in November, Senator Brown and I announced the release of an additional $2 million for streetscape improvements to Allentown, and with everything that's happening in downtown that's desperately needed, and another $400,000 in the heart of the city neighborhood surrounding Sacred Heart. You can't tell me that it wasn't worth it to make that vote. And there's more coming. We accelerated the widening of Route 22. And if you've ever driven in the Lehigh Valley, you've gotten stuck on Route 22. And what we did by voting yes was create a better roadway, a safer roadway, and one that will make it easier for us to recruit new businesses and maintain the ones we already have. That was, if you ask me what vote I remember more than anything else, it's going to be hitting the yes button on Act 89. But it was so worth it. I'm so glad I did it. We're already seeing the positive results.
Well, touching on the Route 22 project, you're actually taking us where exactly I want to go next. And this is locally. We visited your district throughout the past 2 years several times and took a look at some economic development projects, some transportation projects, some programs that work for constituents in your district. Yep. So what are some of the local highlights you can remember for the past 2 years?
One of the things my office was really aggressive on was the unclaimed property program. Nancy in my office, whenever any constituent would walk in or anybody would come in for a meeting for me, would ask for their name, would plug them into their database. People don't realize that 1 in 10 Pennsylvania residents are owed money by the government. We have their money and we want to give it back to them. And I almost feel guilty talking about it sometimes because I say to somebody, hey, do you want us to run your name in the database? That's a scam. No, it's not a scam. We promise. We want to give you back
your
money.
Not giving your name away to anybody else.
Yeah, exactly. Right. And to date, I think we've given back over $300,000 to constituents in the 132nd. And again, their money, we're not, if they owe money, we don't check. It's just a matter of determining determining whether or not we, the government, owes you money, and it can make a huge difference in somebody's life. And that's something we've been really aggressive on.
And will continue to be.
Absolutely. The property tax rent rebate program is probably the most popular government program that we deal with out of my office. That's something which allows folks who are low income or seniors with certain income levels to get a portion of their rent, of their property taxes rebated to them. That's very important. We're always happy to do that. My office location isn't changing as we go into this new term. We're still at 2030 West Tillman Street, right inside the building. They can always call, email, Facebook. There's no shortage of ways to contact my office. And you know, this, the legislation policy stuff is what I do when I'm in Harrisburg, but when I'm at home, it's a matter of finding local problems and coming up with local solutions. And that's what me and that's what my office does.
Okay, and lastly and quickly, give us a preview of what's ahead in 2015.
You know, obviously I'm excited to work with Governor-elect Wolf. It's going to be a fascinating and interesting dynamic here, because the legislature did, after the 2014 elections, become more Republican, but we also overwhelmingly threw out our Republican governor in favor of a Democratic one. So I think the public has handed us a fascinating situation, and one that is going to be very, very interesting to work with. The biggest issue we're looking at is we're staring down the barrel of a $1.9 billion deficit. And, you know, people say government should be run like a business. Absolutely. But businesses have to invest in themselves. And at some point, we need to get serious about our revenue situation if we're actually going to close this deficit and govern responsibly. Everybody wants more money for education. Everybody wants to take care of those who need to be taken care of. And people say that, but when push comes to shove, are you willing to do what it takes to make that money happen? And unfortunately, I think that's the situation that we're looking at right now.
Okay, Representative Schlossberg, once again, thank you so much for your time. We have a lot to talk about with you again in the future, and stop down anytime and update us.
Absolutely. See you soon. Thank you, folks.